two centuries, the Shauna Corporation has used borrowed futuristic technologies to provide Traveller, Python, CG, Skyrim, and bikini videos for the subscribers of this YouTube station.
I couldn't tell what was hurting me. Meanwhile, I'm watching Mora. She took a knee. I'm gonna have to watch that again. I don't know if my soul was being drained or shots were fired. See? That white thing taps him and he dies. Is that what happens to me if I walk into one of those white things floating around? Does it just instant? Because I know if I put the sword back, you know, I take it from the Khajiit and I just put it back, and it's got this weird fiery effect going on, but this is now a unique artifact from Artifakes, so maybe that effect was added to the sword. Okay, so one of those white things comes up to me and starts pushing on me. I'm dead because it instantly drains the soul out of me or something. I don't know. That never happened before.
How can I help?
Do I have a mod installed that makes those white things do something? Because they've never fought me before. They usually just float around and look pretty and don't do anything.
Lead on.
They sort of lead you to where you're supposed to go. You know, they're a plot device. There's no Navmish here, so bringing a follower here is useless. Don't even try. You're just making her mad. Now there's three of them? Oh, where'd she go? Anyway. And then these two, the script jam. I put the sword back. I put it back. Why are you shooting me? I can't move. I'm frozen solid. I put the sword back. Why are you guys shooting at me? You guys should have disappeared. Where's Mora? I stab the wind with my sword. Yeah, Mora was doing the countdown, the final countdown. And so the script was waiting on her. At least the Khajiit is not naked. One thing that used to confuse me all the time was the Khajiit would be naked when I'd come over here. It's like, why isn't he wearing his clothes? Is he that crazy? But for whatever reason, he's wearing the proper outfit, he's clothed. It's only the times where I'll come in here, he's already dead. He's already dead and he's naked. But now, in my playthroughs, when I come here, I can see him fighting. He's actually saying stuff to the pale lady during battle. So that's cool. And he dies as soon as one of those white things taps him on the shoulder. He's dead. I stab at thee. I don't know why I'm collecting these things, because I'm not going to be doing Dragonborn. There's not going to be dragons in this playthrough, is there? The only dragon I've seen with this character is when I peeped my head out of the cave coming out of Helgen. Because that's where I started the game. I started my playthrough at the cave entrance. Right inside the cave. Right when you go inside the cave going back to Helgen.
How can I help?
In that little tunnel there. That's where I did my character creation. Right. I did my character build. Who says that? Who says? I'm not a character build person. I don't believe in such things. People that do character builds don't roleplay at all. It's like, why are they even playing Skyrim? Remember years ago there was a guy on YouTube.
Keep your eyes open.
Every video of his was a character build. Now this is a thief mage. Now this character is going to be a mage warrior. Now my next character is going to be a thief warrior. This is, or maybe they talk like this. And this is how I'm going to make my thief rogue character.
No problem.
These are the mods I'm going to be using to make my thief, mage, warrior, rogue, Dark Brotherhood build.
Isn't he your husband?
No, he isn't. He's the enemy.
Me, I'm more of a random gen guy. I love games where you just randomly generate your character. And that's what you get. That's the character you get.
Out of my way, stranger. Got any ale?
If you don't like the character you rolled, roll another one. But hang on to the other character, because that could be a useful NPC later on. Or a follower character.
You're wrong to come here, stranger. No rest in Dawnstar. I'll buy everything you've dug up. Now, if you'll excuse me.
But some players, they want to get the core rule book of something, and they want to look up all the builds. You know, what do I have to grind to get my character skilled up to do a specific thing in the game? You know, it's like, I'm not here to roleplay, I'm here to kill stuff efficiently and take all the things. It's like, okay. What are you going to do, hobo serial killer? What are you going to do with all the things that you collect?
Bullfrek, I have an order of swords and armor from the local blacksmith coming here. I need every piece polished to a fine shine.
Yes, my lord. We could hardly waste anyone else's precious time on such a tedious task.
Exactly, Bullfrek. You always know your place. Unless you're here to solve this nightmare problem, I don't need you.
Let's leave the fighting to the Stormcloaks.
Don't! You're right. Why dilute the glory with too many souls fighting over it? We'll drive out the Empire and be celebrated as heroes when we win.
If we win, this war's gonna drag on for years. I can feel it. We need to prepare for a long struggle ahead.
Enough of your dire predictions.
If you're here about the nightmares, I'm afraid my pleas to the College of Winterhold go unheard.
Anyways, so I have Force Greed enabled. That's why all this dialogue's happening.
I've been in charge of Dawnstar for over 35 years. Excellent. You've done us a great service. Here is your reward.
Back to another fine day in Dawnstar.
I've tried different mods for him.
You're new here.
For the Jarl.
Trust the new.
Scald, but,
Get going, then.
It all... At the end of the day, I think the vanilla... The vanilla look of Scald is the best.
I have no interest in taking sides in this war.
He just looks like the annoying part. The annoying Nord part. It was good casting, whoever made that NPC. Then I got a letter from Brynna congratulating me on killing all the things in that lighthouse in the last video. That was neat.
You found it. I've been looking for that blade for months. You took on all those bandits yourself? Thank you. Here, my father had a favorite sword and shield technique. Let me teach it to you in honor of his memory. Travel safe.
I think by accident I found his sword. I don't even remember where it was. It wasn't in the usual place, up on the waterfall area.
I'll have to remember that the next time I get a shipment in.
It was north of Dragon's Reach, I think.
There's nothing quite like a good vegetable.
Nazim says little runts like me don't belong in the Cloud District. I hope he trips on the stairs to the market.
Fresh baked loaves.
Do you get to the Cloud District often? Oh, of course you don't. You look like a bandit.
Get lost before I knock you senseless.
Once I've made enough money trading with the Khajiit caravans, I'm going to buy the bannered mare from Hulda.
So all the priorities are rearranged with this.
I spend a lot of time at the market.
All these extra dialogue mods I have installed.
I need more experience if I'm going to run an... I'm here to buy food, Nazim. I suppose you don't need to worry about that. Farewell.
So I can't metagame like I used to. I mean, I can still metagame, but it's not going to work. I don't know when things occur anymore.
They say there's nothing a Nord woman can't do if she puts her mind to it.
She's not telling me about she needs a tusk.
See you.
So that's changed. Some flag has to be set before she'll even mention anything like that.
We Nords are strong. And we're as tough as stone.
She's only going to talk about wanting to run the bannered mare one day.
I spend a lot of time at the market stall so I can learn the merchant's trade. I need more experience if I'm going to run an inn someday. I wish to be much more than just...
But I think what's going on here is my reputation is null and void. Everyone thinks I'm just a scum Imperial. This is Nord territory that I'm in. So no one's going to give me... No one's going to give me anything to do. They just want me to pack up and get out of town.
Make a living traveling the roads and selling their wares. It's got to be tough.
But the minute I do... The minute I kill the first dragon in the game...
Worst thing is,
everyone here wants me to do stuff for them.
Nobody trusts them.
And I become Thane of Whiterun.
Matter of fact, I do.
And then it's just boring as hell after that.
And a Nord knows a liar when she sees one.
Because when you're a Thane of anything in this game, all the NPCs just adore you. You can't do any wrong. There needs to be a mod called Evil Thane.
We Nords are strong.
Dangerous Thanes. Where you're a Thane, but people are like... People talk about you whispering behind your back. Or not whispering behind your back. When people talk about you, it's in whispers. Because they're afraid to say what they're really thinking about you out loud. Because they might disappear in one of the dungeons. Because you could be a bad Thane. You know, you...
There's some company I certainly prefer over others.
You could be a czar of some kind, you know?
The most amazing bard I've ever heard.
You could be one of those,
About the same as everyone else?
Oh, what do they call it?
Folk of elsewhere. Great warriors,
mitigated masquerade. You could be the guy in charge of the mitigated masquerade that's going on.
It's got tropical forests.
Anyone not wearing a mask, you can have sent to, the dungeon for thought crime. That would be a neat thing to be, right?
I'd better get going.
But no, in this game, Thane is only the good guy can be Thane's. And then once you're Thane, you kind of remain a good guy. I mean, you can still get away with murder, but the minute they find out you're a Thane, there's like, oh, okay, no problem. Just don't do it again, Thane. Don't murder everyone in the streets on purpose. Try not to.
Do you get to the Cloud District often?
It's weird, I've never killed Nazim, but on YouTube, he gets murdered a lot by player characters for some reason. So I've got this one lady with me, she's from it's Followers shame, and Companions.
Yorick's sister? Poor child. Magic runs.
She's a battle mage
that's
overpowered, so I thought,
thank you for this.
I'm gonna take her outfit and give her a seductress? Is that the name of her outfit? I wanna say it's a seductress. UUNP. It's very old. It's a very old mod. Comes in one style. There's mods for it to make it different styles and colors, I think. Comes with a ridiculous witchy poo hat from Wizard of Oz or Lord of the Rings. No one wears those in real life. No one wears those in fake life. So she's going along without the hat. Anyway, I'm just playing around with, what is it called? Companions as Followers? Something like that. Where I tell my followers to stand next to me.
Everything's for sale, my friend. You need visit no other shops today.
So she's going to try to stand to my right at all times.
Everything's for sale, my friend. Excellent. Here is your reward.
If she's on camera. If she's not in camera, she's not going to try to be anywhere.
A bit of that.
It's only when she knows she's being on camera. That's when she tries to stand to the right of me. And, you know, the mod was written before these kind of camera angles were even thought of in the game. So, of course, the mod's going to act kind of trippy here and there, depending on where my camera is and what it's doing. What was this Morrowind music playing? That's weird. Takes me back to Elder Scrolls 3. And was it Linda Carter was in that one? And she's like, "Hail, Redguard." Or she'll say, "See any elves?" She didn't have much to say in that game.
Yes? All right, then.
She played a Nord. A noble warrior-type Nord. Maybe a savant, even, if I remember. Or that could have been a mod. I probably had a mod that made more NPCs savants in that game. There's only one savant, I think, in Skyrim, right? And that's Nelloth. He's the only guy who knows anything about...
Is there some way I can assist you?
The whole Skyrim lore?
I understand. Of course.
Because Nelloth knows everything. He knows about Hermaeus Mora. He knows about Elder Scrolls. He knows about vampires. He knows about... He's a high elf himself. He's been... Or not a high elf. He's a... I guess a dark elf. But anyway, either way, he's lived thousands of years, so he's seen it all.
Your businesses, your children, your very lives.
And he's got the best voice actor doing his voice of any game ever of all time. Some say that Ron Perlman's the best voice actor for Fallout, but I don't know. He has a very small bit in that game. I like Max von Sydow. He was a pretty good voice actor too.